ಅನುದಿನಾ ಅನುಕ್ಷಣ ಮನೆಯಲ್ಲೂ ಕಲಿಯೋಣ ಕಲಿಕೆಯ ಹೊಸ ಹಾದಿಯಲ್ಲಿ ಜೊತೆಗೂಡಿ ಹೆಜ್ಜೆಯ ಹಾಕೋಣ ಸಂತಸದಿ ಕಲಿಯೋಣ ನಮ್ಮ ಹೆಮ್ಮೆಯ ಈ ಕ್ಲಾಸಿನಲ್ಲಿ
ಯೆಸ್ ಸರ್
ಯೆಸ್ ಟೀಚರ್
ಪ್ರೆಸೆಂಟ್ ಮ್ಯಾಮ್
Dear students, in the previous session, we learned how to produce magnets artificially. In order to do so, we began with some activities where we found the properties of magnets, the magnetic field around a magnet, how magnetic field is represented by the imaginary magnetic field lines, and the properties of magnetic field lines. Finally, Oersted's experiment. From which we got the relation between electric current and magnetism. That is, to get magnetic field artificially, we use electric current. This is known as magnetic effect of electric current. Dear students, in this session, we are going to explore how to make this finding even better. Let's find a way to get powerful magnets artificially. To do this, we are going to improvise the experiments done by Oersted.
In the previous activity, we have seen the pattern of magnetic field obtained around a straight conductor. Now, we are going to repeat the same experiment, but with little modification. After the initial setup, let us place some small compasses around the conductor and by observing the north pole of the compasses. Notice the disorientation of the direction of the magnetic field. Now, pass the current through the conductor. Here, the electric current is flowing in the upward direction of the conductor. Observe the north pole of the compasses. We can infer that the direction of the magnetic field is in the anticlockwise direction. Change the direction of the current by changing the terminals of the battery and switch on the current. Now the current is flowing in the downward direction. As soon as the current changes its direction, we can notice the direction of the magnetic field also changes. Now it is in the clockwise direction. So, we can say that the direction of the flowing of electric current and the direction of the magnetic field are interlinked. Whenever we have current carrying wires, we need not to repeat the above activity on and on to find the direction of the magnetic field. We call this as a simple rule, namely right hand grip rule.
If you hold the thumb of your right hand in the direction of current flow and encircle the wire with your fingers, as shown, the direction of those fingers will correspond to the direction of magnetic field. This rule is also known as right hand thumb rule. We are looking at a straight current carrying conductor here. The green one is the straight current carrying conductor, and the downward arrow mark which is shown here is the direction of flow of electric current. Now there is no current, it is 0 ampere, therefore no magnetic field around the conductor. Let us increase the current. Say the current is now 3 amperes. You can suddenly observe there is an increase in the magnetic field numbers. These small arrow marks which you are seeing are nothing but magnetic field lines. If you can observe, the magnetic field lines are perpendicular to the direction of the flow of electric current. We can check one thing here. Let us change the direction of electric current. It is now downwards. We are going to change that. Now the current is upwards. Look at the direction of magnetic field. When the current is upward, the magnetic field lines are moving anticlockwise. When the current is downwards, the magnetic field lines are moving in clockwise direction. From this, we can say that the direction of magnetic field lines depends on the direction of flow of electric current. This is one factor which we can prove using this simulator. Let us go to the other factor which was observed in Oster's experiment. Let us increase the current. When the current is increased, say it is 9 amperes now, we can suddenly see the increase in the magnetic field lines. As the current increases, magnetic field lines increase in number, the strength of the magnetic field increases. If the current decreases, the strength of the magnetic field also decreases. So, we can conclude that the strength of the magnetic field around a straight conductor depends on the magnitude of electric current flowing through the conductor. One more thing that we can observe here is the blue object here. This blue object is now inside the magnetic field. What happens if I decrease the current? If I decrease the current, the magnetic field lines also decrease in their number. That means that the strength of the magnetic field near the conductor has decreased. It is away from the magnetic field lines now. If I increase the current, the magnitude of current changes, the magnetic field lines increase in number, this blue object comes inside the magnetic field. If we increase the distance of this blue object from the rod, what happens? If we increase the distance of this object from the rod, our current carrying conductor, the magnetic field decreases. As the direction of electric current changes, the direction of magnetic field also changes. As the quantity of electric current increases, the magnetic field also increases. As the distance from the conductor increases, the intensity of the magnetic field decreases. Dear students, after learning so many things so far, let us look at some questions and evaluate ourselves. Let us look at some questions. These are multiple choice questions. Choose the correct answer. The pattern of magnetic field produced by the straight current carrying conducting wire is in the direction opposite to the current. In the direction parallel to the wire, circular around the wire, in the same direction of current. Correct option is circular around the wire. The strength of magnetic field around a current carrying conductor is inversely proportional to the current and distance, directly proportional to the current and inversely proportional to the distance of the wire, directly proportional to the distance and inversely proportional to the current, inversely proportional to the current and distance from the wire. Correct option is the magnetic field is directly proportional to the current. That is, as the current increases, magnetic field strength increases, but inversely proportional to the distance. That is, as the distance increases, magnetic field strength decreases. From what we observed just now, we get that the magnetic field around a straight conductor will be in the form of concentric circles. This is not the same with bar magnets. In bar magnets, they appear to move from one pole to another pole. They follow a direction. Also, if we bring magnetic lines closer and closer, we can get powerful magnetic fields. Let's go to find a magnetic field which is more stronger. We can achieve this by changing the shape of the strike wire a little bit. We know that magnetic field lines produced around a straight conductor will be in the form of concentric circles. The main objective of this activity is to obtain magnetic field lines which resemble that of magnetic field lines around a bar magnet. In order to do so, we have taken a straight conductor here and marked magnetic field lines on two sheets of paper, as you can see. And the magnetic field directions are also marked with respect to the direction of flow of electric current. This small arrow mark is showing the direction of electric current. I'm going to bend this wire straight conductor a little bit. When I bend it, this turns into form of a circle, and we can see that the magnetic field lines align themselves, as you can see in the picture. On one side, they are anticlockwise, on the other side, they are clockwise. When the current moves upwards, they are anticlockwise. When the current moves downwards, they will be clockwise. We can apply right-hand grip rule also here to find the direction of magnetic field. From this activity, we can see that all the magnetic field lines inside the circular coil or ring are moving in a particular direction. See here, they are moving away from you. When the radius of the concentric circles increase at the center, we can say that all the magnetic field lines will become parallel. There is a logic behind this because they repel each other, they do not intersect, they all move in one direction. Whereas outside, they all are moving towards you. This resembles a magnet, one side of which can be taken as North Pole and another side of which can be taken as South Pole, which is similar to a bar magnet. Even in bar magnet, we see that north is where the point where the magnetic lines of force from south meet inside the magnet. Whereas outside, the magnetic field lines move away from the north and move towards the south. From this activity, we got a little hint that by changing the shape of the straight conductor, we could get a magnet which resembles that of a bar magnet. But this magnet is not so powerful yet. We can see a circular coil connected to a battery here. And we can also observe the charges are moving from positive terminal to negative terminal in this circular coil. As the current flows through the coil, we can understand from the previous experiences that a magnetic field is produced perpendicular to the wire or direction of electric current at all points perpendicular to the conductor. But now we consider the magnetic field only at two places. The magnetic field are moving away from the screen, that is, they are moving towards you at the center. If we change the direction of electric current, that is, if we change positive terminal to negative terminal and vice versa, the direction of magnetic field also changes. It goes inwards. The magnetic field lines are moving into the coil now. We can say that as current changes its direction, the direction of magnetic field also changes. Let us compare the earlier one with the new one. We are changing the terminal, and the magnetic field is also changing its direction. If we increase the voltage to 3 volts, earlier we had 1.5 volts. When the voltage was 1.5 volts, look at the number of magnetic field lines. When we increase to 3 volts, what happens here is the magnetic field strength also increases. That as we increase the voltage, the current increases. As the current in the conductor increases, the strength of magnetic field also increases. And finally, we can see a pin at the center. The pin may experience magnetic field. As the distance between the pin and the wire increases, the pin experiences less magnetic field when the distance between the pin and the radius increases. This is only a representation. As the distance between the center and the coil increases, the magnetic field decreases. We are looking at a circular coil around which iron filings are spread. They are spread in between glass plate so that they distribute evenly, and we are going to connect the ends of the wire to the terminals of the battery. We are passing electric current through the circular coil. We can observe that when we switch on the current, gradually iron filings get aligned. The magnetic field line is produced and the magnetic field lines are affecting the iron filings surrounding them. Gradually, these iron filings align themselves parallelly at the center, and near the coils, they will be circular in nature. Magnetic field lines around the wire will be circular, and at the center, they will be parallel to each other. As we move away from the circular coil, the magnetic field lines are not disturbing the iron filings. These magnetic field lines resemble magnetic field lines produced in a bar magnet. They move from one end to the other end. Outside the coil, they move from north to south, whereas inside the coil, they move from south to north. Let's check what we have learned is right or wrong. Here are some questions. The questions here are multiple choice questions. Choose the correct answer. What is the type of field line of magnetic field passing through the center of the current carrying circular ring? Options are A. Circular, B. Straight line, C. Ellipse, and D. Magnetic field at the center is zero. The correct option is straight line. At the center, there will be parallel lines. Next question. If we increase the number of turns in the circular coil, the magnetic field at the center would, that is, as the radius increases, what happens to the magnetic field at the center? Decrease, increase, neither increase nor decrease, either increase or decrease. The correct answer is increase. When we look at the magnetic field pattern around a circular coil, we can observe that they are parallel at the center. Also, the direction of magnetic field can be changed by changing the direction of electric current. We can use this logic here. As the radius increases, the distance between the conductor and the center increases. So we can say that as the radius increases, the magnetic field strength decreases. The strength of two magnets is greater than the strength of one magnet. So, the magnetic field strength produced by two coils is greater than the magnetic field produced by one coil. In next activity, we are going to use this logic to get a better magnet. In the previous activity, we observed the direction of magnetic field inside a circular coil, and we also studied the pattern of magnetic field produced around a circular coil when electric current flows through the coil. Now we are improvising that activity by increasing the number of turns in the coil. We take a coil and spread the distance of the coil along its axis. We are increasing the number of turns in the coil along its axis like this. This is called as a solenoid when we connect it to a battery. This is a solenoid. We can see that the blue arrow marks are indicating the direction of flow of electric current. On the right side, the current is moving into the coil, and on the left side, the current is leaving the coil. Be sure in the direction of electric current. For that, we can add a battery also. I am representing this by connecting it to a battery. Whenever we do this experiment, though there is no battery connected, please assume that there is a battery connected always. Now we are going to remove this external battery for the purpose of studying it in detail. The current now is zero. There is no current flowing through the solenoid. Number of turns here is 5. No current. Let us increase the current to 3 amperes. When we allow the current to pass through the solenoid, we can suddenly observe a magnetic field produced. And that magnetic field has a particular direction. Inside the circular ring type structure, the magnetic field lines are moving towards you, towards the screen, whereas outside they are moving away from us. They are moving into the screen outside. Let us have a look in another direction. See, inside they are moving towards our left side, whereas outside they are moving towards our right side. Remember, all these magnetic field lines are perpendicular to the direction of flow of electric current here. We can also apply right hand grip rule to find the direction of magnetic field. By applying right hand grip rule, here we can find that the direction of magnetic field lines are in particular direction. Now we are going to increase the number of turns here. We increase the number of turns to 10. When we increase the number of turns to 10, we could see the value of magnetic field here. Its unit is Tesla. When we decrease or increase, we can see that when we increase or decrease the number of turns, the magnetic field lines also increase. The magnetic field strength increases. By the way, this can be compared with a bar magnet. A bar magnet also has one pole and the other pole. From one pole, the magnetic field lines move inside, whereas outside, they move from another pole to the next pole. The pole from which it moves inside is called as south, whereas outside the magnetic field, outside the bar magnet, they move from north to south. Let us increase the current. When we increase the current, magnetic field strength also increases. From this, we can surely say that the magnetic field strength in a solenoid can be controlled, but which is not possible in a bar magnet. In bar magnet, the magnetic field strength is fixed. That can also be done by increasing the coil turn density. There is one more point here. By changing the direction of current, we can change the polarity of the coil as well. Here, left side is north, right side is south. Guess what may happen if the polarity of the current changes, if the direction of current changes. That is, when the current here, left side is entering, right side it's leaving. Now let us reverse the direction of current. Keep looking at the arrows. When we change the direction of arrows, that is, when we change the direction of current, the direction of arrows changed. And also, if you can look at the direction of magnetic field, the direction of magnetic field is in the opposite direction now.
Here we can see magnetic field lines in a solenoid. We have used the iron filings here to get the magnetic field lines. At the edges, we can see that the magnetic field lines are curved. Whereas at the center, they are all parallel. We can say that the magnetic field lines move parallelly in the center, whereas they move from one pole to other pole outside. We can compare this with the other two shapes of conductors that we have already seen. Here is a circular coil, a single coil. The parallel lines are at the center, and the magnetic field strength has increased in solenoid because the increase in the number of turns. If we take single straight conductor, only circular rings all around the straight conductor here. So these are the different types of patterns of magnetic field which we can obtain, and we can clearly say that the magnetic field strength in the solenoid is greatest of all.
We make modifications in the structure of circular coil. Instead of bundling it together, we stretch it along its length. This is called a solenoid. When we connect it to a battery, keeping a soft iron core inside, we can obtain an electromagnet which is more like a bar magnet. Let us compare a bar magnet and a solenoid. The bar magnet is a permanent magnet, whereas a solenoid is an electromagnet. It can act as magnet only if there is current flowing through it. The poles of bar magnet are fixed, whereas for a solenoid, the poles can be altered by changing the direction of electric current. The strength of magnetic field of a bar magnet is fixed, that is, unaltered, whereas the strength of magnetic field of a solenoid depends on the electric current that is passed through it. In this session, we started from the result obtained from Oster's experiment, that is, magnetic field is produced around a conductor when current flows through it. We did so many continuous activities to finally obtain an artificial magnet with the help of electricity. The interesting thing is this artificial magnet or its magnetic field can be controlled. Dear students, after learning so many things so far, let us look at some questions and evaluate ourselves. Let's check what we have learned is right or wrong. Let us look at some multiple choice questions now. The magnetic field inside a solenoid is uniform, weak, zero, non-uniform. The correct option is uniform. Magnetic lines of force inside a current carrying solenoid are perpendicular to axis, along the axis and parallel to each other, parallel inside the solenoid and circular at the ends, circular, along the axis and or parallel to each other. Here are some questions for the homework that you can practice at home and check it with your teachers to find whether they are correct or wrong.
The scientist who discovered the magnetic effect of current is dash. The magnetic field lines around a straight current carrying conductor are in the shape of dash. For the following cases, state the factor on which the strength of a magnetic field depends on. Number 1. Straight current carrying conductor. Number 2. Circular loop carrying current. Number 3. Solenoid.
We did so many continuous activities to finally obtain an artificial magnet with the help of electricity. The interesting thing is this artificial magnet or its magnetic field can be controlled. In our next session, we make use of this artificial powerful magnet to produce moving objects. Have a good day.